Don't lie to me, okay? My glasses make me look like a librarian, right? You know what? I've been wanting to wear them for a long time, and I'm gonna wear them. Wish we could fly away. You and I go to our favorite place. Oh yeah, yeah. Make special memories. Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Karina Bonaduc, and if you are new to my channel, I bought a duplex in August of 2020. I started my YouTube channel in June of 2020 thinking that I would end up buying a house, and then I ended up finding this awesome deal. So I've been mostly renovating it by myself. I haven't done anything like this before, and obviously I made mistakes and I learned some things from them. So here are 10 things that I learned during my time of doing renovations. First off, no matter if you're on YouTube or not, you can never take enough pictures. Sometimes I want to show people and be like super proud of my accomplishments and be like, oh look, I did this, this is how it looked before, and I literally have like maybe 30-40 pictures total and the one video that I posted when I first bought the duplex. But honestly, I should have filled like a whole SD card with like, is it called an SD card? Anyway, I should have filled the whole thing with just pictures from every single angle, all kinds of lightings, like morning, evening, afternoon, whatever. Like I should have taken all the pictures and all the videos. So if you're just starting, just go crazy at it. Number two. This is a given, but a lot of people don't do this, including myself. Keep a budget. I know in the ballpark what I spent and what kind of budget I had for each room and all that, but I don't have actually anything written down. So I feel like that was a mistake. I heard people using QuickBooks, but I tried looking into it and I have no idea how to work it. So I don't have a program to recommend to you, but keep a detailed budget of everything that you spend and you're gonna come out winning, if that makes sense. Number three, I learned this one pretty early on in my renovation. Always make sure that you buy the right paint. And I'm not necessarily talking about color. I'm talking about which kind of paint. You know, you have flat, you have satin, you have semi-gloss, and you also have oil-based paint. So this paint that I bought just said acrylic paint or acrylic something paint, and I had no idea what that meant, and I was like, okay, it's white paint, whatever. So I took it home and it smelled terrible. And not necessarily terrible, but it had a very strong smell. So if you make the same mistake and you bring a paint home and it has the strongest smell that you smelled, it's the wrong paint. Like, you can use it, but it's probably more expensive. It's gonna take a very long time to dry, and it just, you know, might as well not do that, okay? Just learn from my mistakes. This is the whole point of this video, so just do it. Number four, there's probably another better deal out there somewhere, but if it's too good to be true, just buy it, okay? If you don't like it, if it's not the right thing, you can return it. This is America. That's what I learned, okay? You can return pretty much anything for any reason because, again, this is America. And if you're selling anything, don't hate me, okay? It's just my experience. I found a really good deal on a washer and dryer. I actually made a few videos about all the stuff that I found, and they ended up being really good things, and I paid like maybe a quarter of the price on them. So if it's too good to be true, it probably is, but also buy it, okay?
P.S. I'm not a financial advisor, okay? So I'm just telling you what I learned and what my policy is when I buy things.
What is this, number five? If you think something is gonna take very little time, just like double the time that you think it's gonna take, at least, okay? Because I would think that something would take like an hour or two. This car won't stop driving, like stop. Just allow more time for things you think are gonna take very little time, because 100% every single time is gonna take longer, and the simplest things are gonna take longer than something that's more complicated. I can promise you that, okay? I've been trying to build a fence for, I don't know, like 2 or 3 weeks, and it's just not gonna happen. I don't know when it's gonna happen. You'll see the video of it, but if something can be delayed, it will be delayed. If somebody's not gonna, can like not show up, they're not gonna show up. Like, just allow more time. Okay, number six is a really important one. always make a list of what you need to buy, okay? You're gonna get to the store and you're gonna forget what you need to buy, and then I cannot explain how many times I went for something, I bought it, I came home and then I missed something very tiny that I had to go back to the store for. So always make a list and always think about it deeply before you go, because it's gonna save you a lot of time with back and forth, and then you can do even more DIY projects at home because you'll have more time. Number 7. I didn't know about this one, but my neighbor told me that I can actually call about the warranty on the windows. That doesn't apply all the time, and I still didn't get my windows exchanged because COVID. I feel like a lot of contractors and a lot of people in the building industry keep using COVID as an excuse, which it might be true, I can't say or not, but some of them use this excuse for not answering the phone, which is a whole nother story. But even if you buy an old house, you can still have warranty on the windows. Some of my windows have like a little film so you can't super clearly see outside. It's just, I noticed it, it's not a big deal. So I just called to ask, hey, is there anything we can do about this? And they didn't say no, they just said that they have to like get the parts of it, and I still haven't heard back. So technically, I haven't verified this one 100%, but it's a good thing to know in case you buy an old house. Number 8, wrap up everything very well, okay? And how I learned this one is the bathtub comes wrapped in this plastic, right? But to put the drywall and everything on the side, I unwrapped it a little bit and I scratched it. So it's a very tiny scratch, only I know that it's there, but just wrap your bathtub, your shower pan, your furniture, if you're moving, wrap everything very well. Because my pink nightstand is in my shed, it needs to be painted again because it rained the day that it was moved and it has a lot of marks on it, so just wrap everything very well. Number 9. I really wish I knew number 9 before I bought really fancy faucets, but buy regular faucets but in a different color. So instead of buying the chrome, buy black, but don't have them like extremely fancy. Like how mine, like the whole wiring is on the outside of the shower, that is not good. Like if I want to find parts for it, they're very specific parts. But if you have the same shape faucet that is like pretty much standard, and then you just have different color like accessories on the outside, I feel like in time it would be much easier to get them matched. So that's why I had to wait so long to actually install my showers, over a month more than it would have taken if I had a regular shower but just black or oil rub bronze or gold or whatnot. So I feel like this is an important one to know, and later down the road I am scared if my showers ever break, I will have to either break tile and change the whole thing or just have to find very specific parts. So buy regular size faucets, just buy them in different colors and it's still gonna look different and fancier. I feel like number 10 is the most important one of all. Know when you're in over your head and just hire somebody. I have done most of these renovations myself, but again, I have learned a lot of things along the way. I also have another video planned later in time to show you all the little imperfections that I see. Maybe if you come at my house, it won't be the first thing that you look at, but because I did it, I know where they are. So there was a lot of things that I had to learn along the way, and I still want to hire some people for some things that are either too heavy or, you know, too complicated, or you need a license for. So know when you're in over your head and just hire somebody. I hope these things that I learned help you and you get to make less mistakes than I did while you try to renovate your own place. To keep up with what's happening every week, make sure to subscribe, follow on Instagram at Karina Beneduc, on TikTok at Karina Beneduc, and make sure to hit the thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, and I will see you next time. Take care. Mwah. August. Karina Beneduc, why can I never say my name? Every single time I say my name differently, it's because I kind of forgot how to say it. Gonna be talking to you, oh my goodness. I guess we're gonna wait. Just allow more things. Probably all, so buy like regular size faucets and regular. I have done most of the stuff. Why are cars and dogs and everybody going crazy when I'm filming? Okay, I guess I'll cut that.